Welcome to The Advocate, a program that thrashes out all the topical issues of the day.
When you are in government, you don't see nothing wrong with exactly. Whatever is happening.
Self-interest.
The moment you are out there, everything is wrong.
You can't even see many women now, and when they're there, they're not even really making a mark, and then they have an NYSC problem, and this and that.
Really? Disastrous for a president
to even say
to be unaware of the chief justice.
It's a ploy.
It could be a strategy.
That strategy was
a terrible
strategy. Because the buck stops at your table.
Whether it's that we don't look after our cities, and quite frankly, Nigeria has become in a very ugly place.
When you are the only one feeding the people with this news and there is nobody countering them, it becomes, you know, the news. Just as 1 + 1 = 2, so it could be surmised that hate action begets hate speech. No surprises there. Hate speech, guilty as charged. Love those who hate you is a biblical injunction even some Pentecostal pastors in Nigeria will find difficult to keep. So don't blame politicians when they can't stomach a dose of the hatred they dish out to citizens daily. Otherwise, how do you describe the gun-trotting, siren-blaring, neck-breaking speed of political office holders as they chase away other road users while rushing to govern mere mortals like you and I? It's only someone you hate very much that you chase off the road in such manner. You can call it hate chase if you like. So before you charge me for hate speech, the Nigerian government should be aware that its action and inaction does not encourage peace, justice, and harmony, but breed hatred, anger, and disdain from those that should ordinarily love them. Like Fela sang, if I say $1 = 362 naira, it's old news. What if I say government charges 30% import duties on used vehicles and 70% on brand new ones, yet we are not producing or plan to start producing any of these vehicles? You will say it go bad before it good. I told you cement is at 2,550 naira, the highest in the world. How common man go take build house? Government will say we all can't own houses, old story. Government has not even been able to fix electricity supply in 30 years. Despite over $30 billion budgetary provision, you will say now today, dilapidated school structures all over the several states in the country, including the federal government colleges, you will say we are used to it. Some state governors own as much as 30 months' salaries. Yes, we re-elect the governors. Yet the World Bank says it will get worse if these imminent reforms are not carried out by government. If only we know how other countries are growing in leaps and bounds, we will weep for Nigeria. If we have ideas of how other countries are developing policies that will make life better for their citizens, will cover our faces in shame for our dear country. We celebrate mediocrity and applaud backwardness and cluelessness in this country. Does it surprise you that parents are sending their children to schools abroad, including government officials? What is the developmental blueprint for Nigeria? Sorry, strike that out. That's hate speech. Rather than engage in discourse that will endanger meaningful development for all, we celebrate media gagging and debate Jonathan and Buhari as if one is better than the other. Let it be known by government that it's hatred when you make campaign promises and fail to fulfill them. It's hatred when you promise to build a road before election, but after election you leave the road to dilapidate and it leads to the death of many. It's hatred when you create insecurity during and after election and spend government funds without accountability in the name of security votes. It's hatred when you send your children to school abroad, but use the children of the poor and vulnerable to snatch and stuff ballot boxes during election. It's even more hatred when you refuse to pay workers' salaries while your allowances and entitlement are paid even before due date. What's more hatred than this when you empty state treasury to pay pension to a former governor and his deputy who serves the state for a maximum of 8 years, even when he or she has retired to the Senate or is cooling off as a minister, while those that spent 35 years of their youthful years working for government are dying while waiting to collect pensions. It's hatred to allow ASUU go on strike over non-funding of universities while your children are in best schools in Europe and America enjoying best of facility. It's even more hatred when you buy luxury cars for yourself with taxpayers' money, even as you fail to provide good and affordable means of transportation to the people who voted you, into office. Which hatred can be more than when you surround yourself with a mobile police barrack to guard you and your household, when kidnappers and bandits, militants and robbers ride roughshod on the people you have sworn to protect. Hatred, they said, beget hatred. My advocacy today is, if you provide good governance, fulfill campaign promises, encourage transparency and accountability in government, provide a level playing field, irrespective of tribe or tongue, and dispense justice equally and fairly, Nigeria will stand more in brotherhood and would have less hatred to deal with, and government would bother less about whose speech breeds hatred.
Wow.
I have to give you this.
Fantastic.
Wow. I have to give
wow.
you this.
I just my blood was boiling. I wanted to lose my mind as you were talking. My body was just doing, look at what they're doing to us. Yeah. You know, I mean, I feel tearful about Nigeria and what the people are doing
actually
to
wrote
us.
This in tears.
It is absolute
I wrote this
hatred.
Script in tears.
Oh, thank
it's
you
really,
for this.
It's really ridiculous. Why? Okay, so what is the solution? You're advocating for good governance.
Yes.
Because people make promises and they fail the promises. Who are these politicians? These are people who are really hungry. They're career politicians. Mm-hmm. They don't have a sustainable means of income. So they go into government, making promises, get elected, only to fulfill their own needs.
Yeah.
They're really broke.
And those that help
really
them
broke
get
ass people, I'm just telling you. Mm-hmm. And so what we need to do, we have a job with our democracy. The people need to know that they have power. We need to stop election malpractice. I'm a victim. I actually contested House of Reps the last election, and I actually would have won my election. Mm. But leave that's a long story. Mm. What I'm saying is, educated people, people that have an alternative means of income, need to come into governance. People who have actually experience in the private sector, people who have real ideas to bring.
But when you're put up, when you go up against these thugs and these people that, you know, have no morals or no care in the world except to carry out the instructions of their masters, then how will somebody like you
is going to take some time. I mean, the democracy in America is 300 years old. And there's still problems with it. I mean, they haven't used Trump. I'm saying that they don't even have a perfect situation. Mm. The last election that Al Gore lost, hello. This last election that Hillary lost.
Hello.
No,
she lost this fair and square. Let's not forget it was fair and square.
We also don't
mean We're not here talking about Trump because you know me. But the truth is,
democracy is not perfect in any part of the world, even in Canada. What I'm saying is we must fight to make our democracy real for us. And we must encourage people who can keep their promises by their track record.
Well, look, I mean, in that sense, let me take it from where you left off. I mean, I know liberals always want to say, I like what you said in the sense that sometimes it makes it more real. Even when I had to hear you say it for it to sink in even more than when I saw it. So it actually, you need to almost like chronicle it for you to actually appreciate that the people who you've entrusted you're giving your trust to
your
govern, are actually treating you with a lot of despising you, really. So again, Liberals, I want to thank you for that advocacy because I think it's helpful when you chronicle it like that. So we really appreciate how bad things have gotten because sometimes you get used to it, like you say, you go better or now so it be, you know, and you just keep, you know, you keep continuing to continue. But if you look at it like the way Uche was so moved, I'm sure others will be moved as well. You know, we were moved even though we've seen these things. But I was going to just say, on the other side of it is, I feel that we, the people, we sometimes show a kind of hatred in kind because we fail to engage with activism of some sort. We fail to rise up and let our voice be counted. I know, you know, the point that, okay, yes, we're being blocked, we're being gagged, whether on social media, the hate speech, these are things that are holding us back. But love will say, it doesn't matter. If you block me here, I'll push here. The Hong Kong, like Uche often says, the Hong Kong protests. See how long they've been going at
it. The yellow jackets.
I mean, the yellow jackets. So the love will propel you. The people who have gone all the distance, it's love that is propelling them. They can't afford to see the only country they have be decimated like this. And that's what is propelling us here. Because we keep saying, we can't just sit back and keep
which
quiet.
Which for me, I sat back and I look at somebody in government and you're talking about hate speech.
Mm, imagine that.
You're talking, you head yourself out to run for an office and there you say, I criticize you. Mm. It's hatred, it's hate speech. What hatred can be more than what I go through daily in your hands?
Yes. Thank you. Must be hell of a concert. What's happening?
For me, I think because a lot of time people think the problem is rooted in politics or the political biases. But I see two parties in Nigeria all the time. The elite and political class versus the rest of
us. Yes, absolutely.
Those are the two parts.
That's what it is.
And that is why you find out that I can be APC today and Nazi tomorrow, wherever. It doesn't matter. What they are shooting for is what they are shooting for.
Which is to hold on to power.
It's tough to say people need to participate more. But at the same time, I think we must go in that direction. Mm. In the last election, for example, you have situations in which more than a million people registered in a state. Less than 300,000 came out to vote. What were the 700,000 doing?
Sometimes those figures are overblown.
Yeah.
No, but you still know that people didn't engage.
We see like, now.
They feel they can't make a difference.
Because this is a different topic. Wait, this is a different topic.
Don't count.
Wait, this is a different topic altogether.
It's not necessarily a different topic.
No, you know why? Do you know why? Go take census of all the elections in Nigeria. All from 1999 to date. Take the average of the voting age. That's when you know our repopulation. In even the election where they say there's a massive turnout, from what you have at the number of registered voters, it's usually not up to 50% of that voter. Do you know why? During registration, when Jega came on board, that's why I say it's a different topic.
Yeah.
When Jega came on board, he said, look, I need to clean up the register. When they cleaned it up, some figures reduced. Some governors were complaining. Mm. How can you say I have only 2 million voters in my state? Mm. You know, it needs to increase.
Yeah.
So some of this population, they use it to also falsify.
But as we go biometric, that becomes irrelevant.
Not to mention
it becomes irrelevant.
Yes.
Because we need to go biometric.
Electronic voting is the only way forward.
And now, instead of talking about electoral acts, we're more interested in
the speech. There was no electronic voting. You bring your ID card, your name is already on the register. Your ID card, even you don't have to have a voter's card. So there's all these funkified machines and up there. You bring your ID, your valid ID, you go, there's your name on the register, the ticket, you go and it's a tick on a box.
But that's where you have people who it's not life or death for them.
I'm telling you, it was a very, very important
election. It was a very important election.
He was the Prime Minister of Canada. Yeah, what am I saying is, until we have a proper verification system where your ID is actually a true ID.
It doesn't have to be
a voter's card. We don't have to spend so much billions creating a new voter's card. ID.
But I'm for electronic. You know why?
It's still electronic because the electronic means I've already captured to. You.
Yeah.
The census knows how many people in my household. And if I forgot my personal at that point, then you can even be verified again.
The reason why I'm still saying electronic is that I want you to be able to vote from your phone the way they do for Big Brother. Niger.
You can even
if you come out there and the security issue starts again, you'll be hindered.
You can post your ballot.
If I know that I'm on a shift, I'm endangering myself,
and I can't go throughout election day because I'm on 18-hour shift, I can post in my ballot. There's a deadline for that.
But do you know why that is feasible?
You have to use your phone.
Why it is feasible?
Well, every vote must count. We have to make sure.
It might arrive the following
day. It's electronic.
Why it still happen in the United States?
Why it is feasible? Because the data is there, and then there are sanctions.
There
are sanctions, but here it's everything goes. And so once you're a political office holder, you're an emperor. You can do no wrong.
Oh my.
If they realize that if you snatch the ballot box, everything cuts, that means that all those votes will be nullified. You won't do that.
No, but you will
still do it. If you want, I will go to
your area and smash ballot box.
Yes, so that all the votes.
So that once we know that your area is predominantly for one party, you can't snatch that ballot
box. So that
whole
area will be cancelled. In fact, that's what they're doing now.
For the state.
Yes, now.
Yeah. There'll be no result for that state.
Yes,
no,
so
nobody will get the vote.
Yes, like take a place like River State. I'm sure that's what they would have wanted.
It's a hot topic.
Seriously. Time flies when you're debating a hot topic like this. We'll continue to speak because we hope to communicate the truth in love. After the break, Bola will go spiritual on us. I wonder if we need any special preparation to receive this advocacy. Maybe like praise and worship.
I don't know.